blessings, beautiful people. So I'm in the scripture right now, looking at Proverbs 3:5, which reads, "Trust in the Lord with all thine heart and lean not unto thy own understanding." So as I'm reading this scripture, man, I'm it's so easy to trust God, to say I trust God. But that scripture is twofold. You have to trust in God, but you also have to lean not onto your own understanding. Sometimes we can say, man, I trust God. And then we find ourselves in a position that we're leaning on what we think is right, our own understanding. Some of us are going through things in life that, man, we just, it seems like, God, I want to trust you, but I don't see no way I can get out of this. I don't see no way you can help me with this. I don't see no way where you can make a way out of no way. And I just wanted to come on to remind you that if you trust in the Lord and lean not onto your own understanding, God will make a way. God will make a way out of no way. There are so many times in the Bible where we find God making a way out of no way. I know if you look and you sit back and you think on your life, how many times God has come through, how many times God has made a way. Sometimes we forget when we're in the midst of a fire, when we're in the midst of a tough situation. Right now, I'm going through something where, you know, I'm like, man, I'm having to learn to be still and trust in the Lord and not lean to my own understanding. In a situation where I can't figure it out, I can't fix it, I can't make it right, I have to trust God to fix it for me, to step in on my behalf, to make a way out of no way. So I wanted to come on and share that. When we think about scriptures in the Bible, like the children of Israel at the Red Sea and the army behind them, threatening them their lives to kill them. In that moment, they had to trust God. They knew that they didn't have any, there was nothing else. They couldn't lean on what they know. They couldn't lean on their own understanding. They had to trust God to make a way. And they trusted God, and God opened the sea, parted it, showing that there is nothing that God is not willing to do to make sure that you prevail, you win in every situation. And so if once we begin to trust God, and to trust God is to have our confidence, our reliance, that we just gonna rely on him. God, sometimes we gotta get to a place where we go, God, you know, I don't know how I'm gonna make it out of this situation, but I trust that you will make a way for me. I trust that you will provide. I don't know how I'm going to eat, or how I'm going to pay my rent, or how I'm going to pay my car note, or how I'm going to pay my mortgage, how I'm going to pay my credit card bills, how I'm going to pay my student loans, how I'm going to take care of my kids. I don't know, but I trust, I have my confidence, my reliance that you will provide, that you will make a way, that you will be my strong tower, that you will never leave me nor forsake me, that you'll be with me even in the fire, that even if you didn't do one other thing, I know that you've done more than enough, and I know that you will prevail, and I know that you will win, and I know that you will cause me to conquer and tread upon. So if you are going through a season where you are trying to trust God, but you're trying to also lean to your own understanding, let go of what you understand, what you think, because God is eternal. He is able to do things supernaturally, things that you wouldn't even fathom, things that he already is in our tomorrow working out the things of itself. He's taking care of it. So if he's in our tomorrows working out the things of itself, you rest and trust that God has you. He got your back. That he knew long ago, he already made a way out of no way. And so you can trust and rely on him. Just like all the many people in the Bible, Abraham, Moses, David, Isaac, Jacob, all these mighty people in the Bible who God showed up for. And so just like, you got to keep in mind, God never changes. He's immutable, meaning he changes not. He's the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. So if he did it for them, he'll do it for you. If he did it for you, he'll do it for you again. He is the same God right now, same God back then, same God right now. So he will make a way. It just may not look like what we think. Sometimes we may have to get in the fire. But we have to know that God will protect us in the fire. He'll get in it with us. Just the three Hebrew boys, he got in there with them and protected them. And so If you're going through, trust God. Lean not to your own understanding. Begin to acknowledge him in all of your ways and he'll direct your path. Begin to tell him what's on your heart. Don't keep carrying this heavy burden that is upon you. Lay it before his feet. Lay it before his feet. Cast your cares before him and know that he'll do it. He got your back. So I ain't only talking to y'all. I'm talking to myself too. It's encouraging for me. But I hope that blessed you. I love you. I'm gonna pray. So Father God, I want to pray for everyone who is watching, who is going through a tough season in their life where they feel as though, God, they want to give up, they want to quit, they want to let go. I pray, God, that you would intervene on their behalf, that you would touch their hearts, touch their minds, God. I pray that you would move and intervene on their behalf. I pray, God, that you would show them who they are, God, that they are citizens of the kingdom, that they are not in this world's operating system, but they are in the kingdom's operating system. And in the kingdom, you provide all of their needs, that anything that they need is accessible to them, healing, financial provision, understanding, revelation, relationship, strength, love, everything that they need from you is in your operating system, the kingdom in which they are citizens and partakers of. So God, I pray that you would lavish the kingdom on them, that you would show them that they are kingdom citizens, that you provide for them, that you open doors that have been shut, that you make ways out of no way, that you provide financial relief, that you provide healing in their bodies, healing in their thoughts, healing in their hearts, that you remove all fear, that your perfect love began to cast out all fear in their hearts, God. I pray that you would have your way in and through them and through their family. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen. God bless you all. I love you. Most importantly, Jesus loves you. Have a great day. Bye.